Hello, ladies, gentlemen, and otherwise. I'm Lamar Haven. Welcome back to Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past. So, I'm gonna head over here for a moment. You can see there's a cave there, but there also seems to be a well here. Hop on down! And we can enter the well cave. First thing you find are some bombs. So, if you wanted to get bombs, and you didn't want to spend the 50 gold like I did, that was another way to, 50 rupees, sorry, I did, you could just get it from there. And you also get a ton of rupees. So obviously I didn't need to spend the rupees in the last video, but I wanted to do so anyway. Also, you'll find a piece of heart if you are observant enough to notice that there was a crack in the wall. So we already have two pieces of heart. It'd be nice to get a heart container before the next dungeon. And it might be possible to do so, but I don't think I remember what location most of the pieces of heart are. So to the north is a forest that we're not going to be able to enter just yet. And it occurs to me we never actually went to the Elder's house to find out where he was, or find out that we couldn't find him.
Who? Oh, it's you, Haven. What can I do for you, young man? The Elder. Oh, no one has seen him since the wizard began collecting victims. What? Master Sword? Well, I don't remember the details exactly, but long ago, a prosperous people known as the Hylia inhabited this land. Legend tells of many treasures that the Hylia hid throughout the land. The Master Sword, a mighty blade forged against those with evil hearts, is one of them. People say that it now is sleeping deep in the forest. You understand the legend? Yes. Anyway, look for the Elder. There must be someone in the village who knows where he is. You take care now, Haven.
Of course, it's his grandson. So, this extra room is just to demonstrate. They might have a rocky marriage. Anyway, now that we've got that information, yes, apparently the Master Sword is hidden in the forest. However, we cannot enter the forest yet, and it wouldn't matter if we could. We are now introduced to that odd thing. Not entirely sure what it is, and I remember I forgot to talk to her. Again, it's just another panicked villager misunderstanding the situation. Okay. I also didn't go inside that house, and I haven't checked what's over here or over here. Why don't we go this way first? A library? Interesting. Also, it's offset. Wouldn't it make more sense to clear these out and have the building move, like, one spot over? Isn't that a thing that could happen? Guess not. Actually, that isn't a thing that can happen. Anyway, in here, you are surrounded by books. But you see, there's a book up here. But we can't get to it. I guess we'll have to find another way to get that book at some point. Yeah, Haven, now I'm quarreling with my younger brother. I sealed the door to his room. Dude. That is completely reasonable. I have a sibling. But I will fix the problem! Hey, Haven, did you come from my older brother's room? Is he still angry? Yes. If you can reach the goal within 15 seconds, we will give you something good. Ready, set, go! Alright, so go as fast as you can. Unfortunately, without certain tools, this isn't going to be very fast. As you can see, I took the worst path possible. Your time was 21 seconds. You're not qualified. Too bad. Why don't you try again? See, you can't actually do this fast enough unless you're insanely good at your movement. Sorry, you are really, really good at your movement. But you can with certain tools that you will get later. Pay 20 rupees and I'll let you open one chest. You can keep what is inside. Open a chest. Alright, open the chest you like. Aww. Can't open any more chests. The game is over. So I'm going to try one more time. Just for funsies. middle. 50 rupees. So it's paid for itself. Unfortunately, I'm pretty sure the only thing you can get from that gambling is just rupees. So if we head down here and fight you, because you're a jerk, sir. Go through here. So when I was a kid, the arrows always looked like battle axes to me. What a mysterious boy. And all those wonderful animals that you just saw? Yeah, you'll never see their sprites again. They don't reuse them, which is actually rather surprising. Anyway, that was a mysterious boy with a mysterious magical instrument. I suppose it was supposed to be an ocarina? An ocarina. You know, nobody knew what the hell an ocarina was until Legend of Zelda, probably. I can't imagine it was a very popular musical instrument. Introduced to enemies with bows, but we're also introduced to the fact that Link needs more weight training. Can't lift those boulders. Oh well. Just enjoy the music. Classic, isn't it? Okay, enough of that. As you can see, we're extremely close to our destination. So, if we go across the bridge, as it was shown in the map, we should be able to get there pretty quickly. Oh, slow down! I'm just skipping those enemies because there really is no point to it. Oh my, a cave! Okay, and there's also a lot of guards around this cave. That makes me suspicious. I will soothe your wounds and comfort your weariness. Close your eyes and relax. Yeah, it's just a full heal. Onward! Hey, Octorok, quit it. At least I think those are Octoroks, they might not be. Ooh, what interesting statues. And yes, your shield actually has a function in this game. If it's in front of you and a minor projectile comes your way, you will block it. Of course, you have to have enough... What's the word I'm looking for? Nah, forget it. I am indeed Sahasrara, the village elder and a descendant of the Seven Wise Men. Oh, really? Haven, I am surprised a young man like you is searching for the Sword of Evil's Bane. Not just anyone can use that weapon. Legends say only the hero who has won the three pendants can wield the sword. Do you really want to find it? Yeah, or of course! Good. As a test, can you retrieve the Pendant of Courage from the East Palace? If you bring it here, I will tell you more about the legend and give you a magical artifact. Now go forward to the palace. But first, sir, it appears you have a hole in your wall. See? 50 rupees, bombs, and 50 rupees. So if somehow you didn't have bombs before, how'd you get into that room? So these other statues, as you can see, when you get close enough to them, animate and attack you. But we got arrows on the deal. I like going up here and around for no reason, because it's actually longer to do so. It's just nice to see all the ruins everywhere and how they play a role into how you can travel. Alright. However, we can skip this statue to go up these stairs. Skip this statue, go up these stairs, because apparently statues can't climb stairs. They're like Daleks that way. And into the East Palace. The first dungeon of the game. I just wanted to demonstrate that by picking up that pot, you'd open up the button that you needed. However, here is just a bottomless pit. Or is it? I think it is. Anyway, now that we just picked up the pot and revealed the button, you can see that the button is still revealed. And as you can see, another dead end. I just like demonstrating that. Because it's a game design choice. So you have to realize, wait, that means there has to be a button in the next room. And here, your instinct would be to go right after the enemies. So you'd probably press that button that you can barely see on the floor there. And here you hear a noise before you see these come out. Bowling balls. Or, oh dear! I didn't remember the timing for the big ball. That's what she said. Anyway, I like to come up here and get this chest before I move on because 100 rupees. Yeah, I don't think they have wallet sizes in this game, so you just start out with the maximum of 999. At least I think so. I could be wrong. It has been a very long time since I've played this game. While the dungeon music in this game is very atmospheric, I'm afraid it isn't terribly unique. They don't have different dungeon themes for different levels or anything like that, but the game more than makes up for it in other ways, and it's pretty iconic of a theme anyway, even if it seems a little repeating at points. Of course, I have just, I've just criticized, even lightly, an aspect of Legend of Zelda Link to the Past, so I'm sure I'm going to get people that want to kill me. Alright, and one more pot to get rid of the last Stalfos. I think they're Stalfoses, at least. I don't know if each different type of skeleton has its own name. But now we have found the compass. Now you can pinpoint the lair of the dungeon's evil master. So if you press X, you can see there's now a skull on the second floor on the left side, and on the second floor of the map on the upper right corner, you can, the upper left corner of the map, upper right corner of the screen, you can see a skull. But since we don't have the map, it doesn't really mean much to us just yet. In later games of the series, you would also get a location of chests and the like. Haven, it is I, Sahasrara. I can talk to you telepathically when you touch these tiles. Here's a hint. You can use the treasure hidden in this palace to defeat armored foes. Interesting. So the treasure in this palace is a weapon of some kind. Unfortunately, here we can only move that block that way. And it will reset when I leave the room, no worries. That is simply a shortcut of way back. Speaking of armored foes, there seems to be one asleep near the up top there. And, it's locked. If you have the big key, you might be able to open it. So, as you can see, not only is the big key used for big doors like that one, they're also used for opening chests. Quit it. Now you know why I used the pots in the previous room. It's an interesting little 3D-ish effect, having layered areas, and they use it to a very good advantage in many other parts of this game. Oh dear. So the first thing you want to do is move in a clockwise fashion to avoid these guys. They're called anti-fairies, I believe. And unfortunately, there's nothing much we can do to stop them at this point in the game. Hey. Stop moving. There you go. Now you've stopped moving. Permanently. Hey. Alright, and we got our key. And some more magic. Which, unfortunately, since we only have one thing to use magic on, not terribly useful yet. Alright, so once again, we want to move in a clockwise fashion. Give me that. So we can go in this door. And now we're up here, in the previous room. And we can go through this door we saw earlier. That seems to be a rune of some kind. If we defeat these enemies, including the almond one that we can only harm when his eye is open. Get back here. Sometimes I just like sticking out my sword like that and stabbing them, because they won't dodge that. They'll only dodge the slash attack. See? Alright, so now we have to awake you. Ooh, I got a double attack on that spin. Alright, there is a way to just take damage and use the invincibility frames to get that pot, but I prefer to actually kill enemies. We're not speedrunning here. And we got the big key! That allows us to go through this door to the north, which is a shortcut to the room where we saw earlier. This is a very efficient dungeon that's mostly about tutorializing and teaching you how to do a dungeon while still being difficult enough to be able to be called a dungeon, especially when it's only the first one. So now we have gotten the bow. You can shoot arrows until you run out, and immediately it spawns enemies. But because we already have 30 arrows, which I believe is our max at the moment, oh dear, they're everywhere! We can now use it as a weapon, and if you jumped into those pots, I believe they take you to the beginning. I used to know the exact pixel-perfect position to be able to hit all of those enemies with one spin attack. Oopsies. Come on. Wakey wakey! Ow. That hurt more than I expected. Maybe I should have used these. So as you can see, we do have a key, so we can go that way. However, I kind of want to see what's this way. Ah, money, money, money! Money! As you can see, it's still getting darker. Yeah. It's, the torches can carry over to other rooms. Like that. Okay, just anti-fairies in here. Ah! Okay, so not only did it deal me damage, but you might have noticed that the thing also drained some of my magic. Ooh. Alright, we want to be very careful here. Let's try and wake up. I was about to say, let's try to wake up only one at a time, but you know how well that went. Upsy-daisy. Alright, I really should have brought a health pot with me just so we wouldn't have to hear the beeping constantly. An unfortunate fact of the Zelda games, Legend of Zelda games, is that beeping when you're low on health. So the upper left button is one you want to get to as quickly as possible because that room just gets more dangerous the longer you're in it, really. There we go. Unlike his brothers, the red one takes two arrow shots, so be ready. There we go. As you can see, the distance for the spin attack is ever so slightly larger than your actual hitbox for a normal sword attack. As you can see, the red ones do not take damage from pots. I believe the blue ones could. There we go. And here we have the boss, whose name completely escapes me. Hold on. There we go. I think this is the right position. There's a position you can have where you will, if you just stand there and shoot your arrows, you'll always kill all of them. Not exactly a huge threat. They just move in a formation. You can attack them with your sword instead of just the arrows if you want. And then when you get to the final one, all you have to do is stand there and stab your sword. Just hold the button. He'll keep running into it. See? And for our efforts, we get the heart container and the amulet of courage. I didn't forget what the amulet was called for a minute there. How dare you accuse me of that? Pendant! Okay, maybe your accusation could have been accurate. Take it to Sahasrara. Two pendants remain. Ding! And it teleports us out of the dungeon, thankfully. However, my arrow count is still pretty low. We'll have to do something about that in a bit. However, let's go straight to Sahasrara. I mean, he is just outside. See? Right here. Now, if you didn't have bombs yet... Oh, you got the Pendant of Courage. Now I'll tell you more about the legend. 3 or 4 generations ago,
An order of knights protected the royalty of Hylia. These knights of Hyrule were also guardians of the Pendant of Courage. Unfortunately, most of them were destroyed in the Great War against Evil that took place when the Seven Wise Men created their seal. Among the descendants of the Knights of Hyrule, a hero must appear. I see. Haven, I believe you. You should get the remaining pendants and carry this with you. This is a treasure passed down by the families of the Wise Men. I want you to have it.
We have gotten the Pegasus Boots. He gives you the Pegasus Shoes. Now you can execute a devastating dash attack. Hold the A button for a short time. Helpful item is hidden in the cave to the east side of Hylia Lake. Get it.
Alright, so now that we have the Pegasus Shoes, we have a lot of things we can explore. And we can travel faster, except going upstairs. I always love doing that when I first get Pegasus Shoes. It's kind of a tradition. Alright. Oopsies. Well, we can just leave this way. So as long as you're not facing a wall or something, you hold A and you get to dash attack. And I'm going to be using this to travel the overworld a lot. Alright, so we said the east of Hylia Lake. This is the Hylia Lake, so I kind of assume he wants us to go into that cave that I see. Let's go see if we can get there, shall we? Oopsies. I'm being kind of reckless. Gimme. Alright. I have to say, it's good to be back to recording and such. I had a hectic as all hell last week, and this wasn't the game I originally planned to do this week, but it works! Hey, look! Another shop. If you wanted to buy bombs there instead. It's exactly the same as the one in the town. Quit it. Yeah, I have a shield. Sucks, don't it? Alright, let's see what's in here. It's another fortune teller. Useless to me. Because I am all-knowing. Just to demonstrate. See that dark water? You can't walk on dark water. You have to swim. And unfortunately, Link is water-soluble. Alright, let's see if we can get to Hylia Lake through a different way, So let's go and do that, and then there's something we need to do near the village as well. So, one thing about the, you remember the wall that was behind the Elder? Well, if you did not have bombs at that point, which is entirely reasonable, maybe you didn't explore as much as you might have wanted to, you would have noticed that specific wall looks slightly different from other exploding walls. That's because, explodable walls. That is because you could have used the Pegasus Boots to have gotten in. And now we found another fairy fountain. Pretty thick with it in the beginning of the game, but it's just more of a demonstration that the more you explore, the more rewards you're gonna get. In the thick fields of Hyrule, we leave and head south and east towards the lake. Ow! And that's why you don't dash recklessly everywhere. I just wanted to demonstrate that before checking this wall. And we see critters! Alright, so here is hoping you have decent aim with your bow. Ah, darn it. I like to just wait for them to come to me. Ugh. Actually, it might be easier if I do this. Come on, come to me. No, that's right, they're immune to that sort of nonsense. Well, there is another option. Oopsies. Stop throwing bombs down a cliff. There we go. And even though they're way over there, see? It's a good demonstration of trying to find all the limits of your current tools. Take some rupees, but don't let anyone know I gave them to you. Keep it between us, okay? Ba-ba-ba-bum! Ba-ba-ba-bums! We just cleaned him out, didn't we? Yep, we have 828 rupees, so anything we want to spend rupees on, we're pretty set for now. Alright, let's go ahead and switch back to the bombs, shall we? Oh, and in case you didn't notice on the pause screen, you could have seen that the Pendant of Courage on the right, see pendants. You can also see our equipment, level 1, and kind of dinky. We have options, though. Don't worry! Hello, everybody. There we go. That's pretty much the only way you have to kill these guys. Well, actually, no. We have bows and arrows. What am I talking about? Yep, killing that enemy spawns these everywhere. I don't think you can actually attack those, so... You don't see those on enemies very often, but when you do, just avoid them. There's no reason to really fight them. Alright, so here we are in the cave that the Elder mentioned. Oh my. It seems to be frozen, and we have the music of a fairy fountain. Fairies! If you had a net, you could catch them. Alright, so here you want to look for the right block to push. That's odd. Seems we can't push any of these blocks, but there's a chest right there! Maybe this wasn't the cave the Elder mentioned. Or at least not the entrance. But where's the other entrance? Where could it be? I have no idea. It's right there. So again, that's just to demonstrate, in case you haven't figured it out now, that you can bomb walls. And we got the ice rod. Its chill magic blasts the air, but watch your magic meter. So we now have a magic item that is entirely based on using magic, like the torch. Only this one has a more offensive measure. Hold on. There we go. As you can see, it deals some damage to the enemy and freezes them in place. It also has many other functions, but we're not going to find some of them until it becomes more useful later. This game does a very good job of letting you find some of your tools and weapons and stuff outside of dungeons as well as inside of them, and then making them useful later. Anyway, I'm going to go meet you near the village, where we're going to have some other things to look for. So, the first thing we're going to do is enter the library. As you can see, by bashing into the bookcase, we have the book drop. You found the Book of Medora. You can use it to read the ancient language of the Hylia. It's a translation book, and it's going to be very important for later in the game. So next, we're going to go take care of this. Hopefully, now that we have the Pegasus boots, we'll be fast enough to be able to beat the time we need, so we can get the other piece of heart. Alright. Just gotta move as fast as you can. Oopsies. And not hit the walls like that. Alright, and then just down here. And ta-da! 13 seconds! You qualified! Congratulations! I present you with a piece of heart. Alright, just be careful not to accidentally walk off the edge. And you get the piece of heart. We now have 3 of 4. Alright, there's one other thing I want to demonstrate, and yes, it's something that I could have shown in the first video, but neglected to. Partially because I wasn't entirely sure I remembered where to get it, and two, because I honestly didn't think we needed it quite yet, and I probably should have gotten it. And it is right here, the mysterious house that we hadn't entered just yet. It wasn't this building. Shut up! It's one of these buildings, I'm sure of it. There it is. It's a poor bedridden boy. I can't go outside because I'm sick. People say I caught this cold from the evil air that's coming down off the mountain. This is my bug catching net. I'll use it when I'm better, but for now I'll lend it to you. You borrowed the bug catcher net. There may be some other things you can catch with it too. So, we now have the bug catching net, which in this game you use to fill up your bottles. I could have already had this and filled it up with those fairies we saw, or maybe some various other things, but I didn't. However, that's going to do it for this episode. We have gotten a lot of items already, and we've only cleared one dungeon. So next time, we're going to head to the next one. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.